a high-tech product, such as a scuba diving regulator or buoyancy compensator, requires a long and painstaking process of designing and testing before it can be manufactured and used by scuba divers. It all begins with a concept based on divers' requirements and developed by experienced product designers and engineers. Once the final design has been established, the drawings are converted to a computer-aided design, or CAD model, and all elements and parts are defined in great detail. Engineers and designers examine all aspects of the project, making changes and adjustments until the desired result is achieved. During this process, the most advanced materials and state-of-the-art technologies are used. At the same time, the requirements of actual production in the factory are analyzed and planned. This ensures that production will start as soon as the product is finalized after testing and certification. The changes and adjustments that have been discussed in the meetings are brought back to the modern equivalent of the drawing table, the CAD workstation, where adjustments are fed into the design, and finally, a physical prototype can be created. A similar process is employed for all products, regulator systems, instruments, buoyancy compensators, and all their components. The first prototypes are carefully assembled for initial testing in the research and development laboratory, where the actual performances will be compared with the design specifications through various testing cycles. Every time something is not to spec, the engineering and design teams will make changes and repeat the process until the pre-production model is ready for in-water testing. The unsteam machine is a key instrument in this process. This sophisticated piece of equipment is able to simulate a diver breathing from a diving regulator and is used to test and measure the regulator's performance. All parameters of the breathing cycle can be monitored and adjusted to simulate different diving conditions. The machine is also used to verify that the regulator complies with the requirements of the stringent EN250 European standard. Results are analyzed after each test to review the prototype performances and make all necessary adjustments to further refine the design. When the prototype is ready, testing proceeds in the pool and in the ocean, with expert test divers breathing through the regulator. This allows to test, in real use conditions, the mechanical performance of the device, the level of comfort, the ease of adjustment, and the use in real diving conditions. Test diving is performed in different environments, in locations all over the world, exposing the product being tested to conditions ranging from tropical to ice diving. While open water testing is being carried on, all the mechanical components of the product undergo long cycles of stress testing in the research and development laboratory. This helps prevent the problems that may appear after heavy use. All of this is part of the internal validation process mandatory for each product. This long and strict process sees the product exposed to mechanical and environmental stress levels way above those it will meet in actual use. Products are tested against the effects of UV light, aggression from salt and chlorinated waters, and extremely cold water. Cold water testing requires the unsteam machine once again. The regulator is cycled at a water temperature in excess of the minimum required by the certification standards to ensure it will operate correctly in all conditions. During this kind of test, it's not infrequent for ice crystals to form and accumulate on the outside surface of the regulator, which nonetheless keeps working even in this extreme situation. When the development and certification processes are complete, the new product is ready to be mass manufactured in the production facility next door to the R&D department.